Mind your decisions, Presh Talwalkar here. The American Invitational Mathematics Examination, or AIME for short, is a qualifying test in America for the International Mathematical Olympiad. It's a 3-hour test that involves 15 questions, and calculators are not allowed. Every answer is a whole number from 0 to 999 inclusive. In this video, we'll cover problem 7 from the 1984 exam. The function f is defined on the integers and satisfies f of n is equal to n minus 3 if n is greater than or equal to 1000, and it's equal to f of n plus 5 if n is less than 1000. The question is, what is f of 84? I thank Henry from the Philippines for suggesting this problem. Pause the video if you'd like to give it a try, and when you're ready, keep watching to learn how to solve this problem. So if you're like me, you tried to solve this problem by directly calculating f of 84. Since 84 is less than 1000, this is equal to f of 89. Since 89 is less than 1000, this is equal to f of 94. If you try working this direction a little further, it feels like you're trying to open a Russian doll. Each time you're trying to simplify the problem, you end up with a copy of the problem, and it doesn't seem to be getting any simpler. It just seems to be getting more and more nested. And eventually, you're not getting anywhere. So sometimes when you try and solve a problem, you end up with a dead end. But don't despair. Try another approach. Rather than directly trying to calculate f of 84, let's try working from the other direction. Let's try calculating from values around 1000. What is f of 999? By definition, this is equal to f of 1004. Now, by definition, f of 1004 is equal to n minus 3, which is 1001. Now we apply the definition once more, and we get the answer of 998. We'll do a similar thing to calculate f of 998. We apply the definition of f, and we end up with 997. Let's try working out a few more examples. What's f of 997? Well, we work through the definition of f, and we get to f of 999. Luckily, we've just calculated that this is equal to 998. We can do a similar calculation for f of 996. We get to f of 998, and this is equal to 997. Let's calculate a few more. What's f of 995? We work through the definition and we get to f of 997, which is equal to 998. F of 994 will be equal to f of 998, and that's equal to 997. So we see a pattern emerging. For values less than 1000, f of an odd number is equal to 998. And f of an even number is equal to 997. You can prove this by induction. Ultimately, we get that f of 84, since 84 is an even number, will be equal to 997. And that's our answer. Now, I just want to do a little extension for fun. This problem can actually be solved very elegantly and very simply using computer code. Now, I know it's a problem from a 1984 exam, but we can actually use modern computer code like Python to solve this very quickly. So we want to define a function doll of n. If n is greater than or equal to 1000, we want to get the value of n minus 3. Otherwise, we want to get the value of f of n plus 5. This will be written as return doll of n plus 5. And this is something pretty interesting. We're defining the function doll in terms of the function doll. This is an example of recursion, and we'll use it to solve this problem. Now you just type in this code, and then type in print the value of doll of 84, and you'll get the answer of 997 instantly. It's amazing that Python can solve this problem so quickly, and all you need to do is type in the definition of the function. So this is a great problem from a 1984 test, and the problem can illustrate the power of computer code. Thanks for being the best subscribers on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and thanks for your support.